I wanted to figure out, you know, what type of youth minister it was that God had created me to be. I think what happens, especially in youth ministry with youth ministers, is that we along the road collect a so-called bag of tricks. You know, we have a bag of things that we, games that we should play, events and outings that we should do, things that we should teach on, and then we use them up until we run out of them. And when we run out of them, that's usually when we decide, oh, it's time to go to another church.
Methods and the the type of instruction that worked for me didn't really work for every student, and it didn't work for a lot of the students. And so I've had to learn the language of students in ways that I didn't think I would have to. I thought I had it figured out. I thought I knew. I learned through failure more than I learned from any training that I got in school or training from a book. I learned by failing more often than not.
I was kind of running out of other guys' ideas. And so it was kind of like, okay, it's really time to figure out who I am. And, you know, Marco's cohort was the perfect opportunity for me to do that.
You know, I thought that Marco was going to write a prescription and send us with it and say, this is what you should try, and this is what you should do.
I fully expected that all of my youth ministry models that I had been working on would be honed and refined, and that he would give me some really good talking points. He would give me some advice about what games to play and what games not to play, give me some structural, like, oh, you shouldn't meet on this night of the week, or you should meet on this night of the week.
It was almost like if we did the cohort and we trained under Marco, it was like we were you know, walking in minor league ball players and we were coming out guns in the big league, almost like, you know, we would have some kind of special forces youth ministry knowledge that would put us on a bigger league playing field. And that's exactly what it wasn't.
You know, he doesn't say, this is me and you should go and do this because this is going to be most effective. But he says, who are you? Who has God made you to be? And how is God planning to use you where you are? In the context that he's placed you in.
It was more about personal health as an individual and figuring out who Christ had created me to be and what my values were as a person and how that translated into my ministry values. And did my ministry values line up with the church that I was serving at? And I wouldn't trade it for anything, but might not have initially signed up for it if I knew that's what it was. I think before the coaching program, I could say that I led my student ministry based on other guys' models. You know, after the cohort and after the training, figuring out, okay, God called me to this church for this specific time and place. This is who I am. This is what I value. This is what I value about student ministry. These are my student ministry values. This is the value of the church. This is the context to the culture of our community. Now what does it look like to minister to our kids? And so I feel like instead of using somebody else's model, now I really feel like we've tapped in and got in line where it is that, you know, God wants us to go, where who he created me to be. And what we're seeing is a much healthier ministry. One of the coolest things is I can honestly say that our student ministry department now 100% lines up with the values of our church.
For us, it has solidified a group of our staff in ways that there's no way it would happen. We're still closer to the other guys that were in our cohort than anybody else on staff, even people that we work closer with.
Well, first off, I would tell them to put that other youth worker's book down. Stop comparing yourself to a church with a completely different context, a culture, and a different budget than you have. And it's time that you it took some time to figure out, you know, who it is that God created you to be as a youth minister, and what it looks like for you to lead a youth ministry. It's a great chance to figure out how to have longevity in youth ministry, because our students deserve it, our churches deserve it, and our communities deserve to have tenured, long-lasting youth workers.
I would say absolutely do it. There are no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Rework your budget, make it possible. But if you really want to experience deep, meaningful change in your own life and in the life of your ministry, it's for you.
I would tell the senior pastors, if you can afford to salary a youth worker, you can afford to salary to send somebody to the cohort, the youth ministry coaching program, because what you can't afford as a senior pastor is 16-month stops on the youth pastor job circuit.
I would, having experienced it, it's one of the greatest gifts that our senior leadership has given to us.
There's nothing that compares to it. Every time we came back from a session when we all met together, I felt energized in ways that I've never felt coming back from a conference.
It's not a question of you can't afford to. It's a question that you can't, you know, it's the answer that you can't afford not to. I figure that there, like, if you're going to study youth ministry, there's no better person in the country to study youth ministry under than Mark Ostreicher. He's kind of like the Yoda of student ministries, if you will. He's been there, done that. He's been all over the country, all different denominations, all different models of ministry, different contexts, cultures, and stuff. And so if you're going to gain any student ministry wisdom, then Marco's the guy to impart it.